Hey devs, welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new to this channel, I invite you to subscribe and join us. In this video, we will debug an event listener. Events are many, like mouse events, touch events, keyboard events, form events, window events, document events. We are dealing with a window event in jQuery. Similar approach can be used in vanilla JavaScript. So what are events? Window load is an event. It's triggered when the page content is loaded. Window resize is an event. It's triggered when browser window is resized. Window scroll is an event. It's triggered when user scrolls down a web page. So this is window scroll. And window resize is this one. This is window resize. And this is also window resize. You can add different event listeners to read these events when they get triggered in web browser. Now, why do we need to read these events? Maybe you want to perform some kind of action when user scrolls down. You have seen sticky header example, right? When user scrolls down, header sticks to the top of the window and moves below as user scrolls down the page. Maybe you want to perform some action when window is resized to a certain device width. So this is why events are very important. Events are there and you can read them or catch them as they happen. These help in DOM manipulation effectively. So this was little intro for the events and event listeners. Now about this video, I want to detect if user scrolls down the page. Really simple task. We will create the HTML page, CSS file and JS file. We will see if we can detect the window scroll or not. So this is jQuery.scroll. Bind an event handler to the scroll JavaScript event or trigger that event on an element. So the syntax is like this: element.scroll function. I've got this page index.html and I've got my CSS file and I've got this custom.js file. I have got an assets folder, my scripts are in scripts folder, and style file custom.scss file is in styles file. This custom.scss file will be converted into custom.css file. So let's create our document. So I will need jQuery. I don't need Bootstrap, but it is here. And I have got my script custom.js. That is in the assets folder and then in scripts folder. And I do not need all of this. So we will just use class container, and here is the dummy text, and then we don't need icon, and I will remove all of this, and I do not need font awesome. Twitter Bootstrap is fine. Okay, so this is our HTML document. And as you can see, let me use some spaces. So this document should scroll, so let's add some height. So now this page can scroll, right? So we want to detect scroll event. Right click and click at the inspect and then come to console. We want to detect this scroll. Let's add some CSS. So HTML and then body. I am using sass. This sass will be converted into custom.css file that is being used here. So height 100%, width 100%, height 100%. So height is 100% for HTML and the body. And then what I would like to use here is overflow and overflow X that I want to use as hidden. So overflow X hidden, height 100%. So let's use overflow X hidden in the HTML as well. So again, this is our page and it is scrolling. Now we want to detect this scrolling. So this is our custom.js file. So let's use window scroll function and console.log window scrolled simple console.log. Let's see, refresh, scroll, nothing is here. Window, let's use on scroll. Nothing happens. Let's revert it and console.log some text. So let's see if this file is working correctly or not. So this file is working. We have included custom.js in the document, so alright, so jQuery, you can try your jQuery like this or like this as well. So document ready, DOM is ready. Let's see if this is working or not. So this is working, DOM is ready. And there are other events as well. Like window resize. Window resized. So DOM is ready and window is resized. As you can see, window is resized. So document.read is working and window resized is working. but if you scroll the page, window.scroll is not working. Let's try more events. There is window load, window.load, and window content. Content loaded. Let's see if this works. So on load, so content loaded, DOM is ready, resize is working, but scroll is not working. All right, so document dot scroll, document dot, let's use document dot scroll. Document scrolled. Content loaded. DOM is ready. Resize is working. But scroll is not working. Window.scroll is not working. Why? It is dot scroll function, we are using it correctly, and there are no errors in console, so what's the problem? I am able to scroll the window, so let's remove body height. Refresh, scroll, and now these are working. Now document scroll and window scroll are working. When you remove height, body height 100%, but you need height 100% for body in many scenarios, so you want to keep this one. So let's remove this one. HTML, let's remove hide from the HTML. So now it is also working. Window scroll is working now. But sometimes you need hide 100% for HTML as well. Let's remove this one, overflow X hidden. Content loaded, DOM ready, and resize is working, and now document scrolled and window scrolled is also working. So the solution is to not use overflow X hidden for HTML, or you can use this one, min height 100% for HTML instead of just height. This will also work. So window resize is working, DOM is ready, content loaded, and scroll is also working. So as you can see, that problem was in the CSS, not in the JS. So we wanted to detect if user scrolls down the page. So we wanted a mechanism to detect user scroll. That is a simple task, and our CSS was the problem, and the problem was due to overflow X or height in the HTML for the HTML tag. So as you see, scroll X hidden or hide from CSS can disable window scroll event, and it's not even scroll dash Y, it was scroll dash X. In this case, CSS is setting the rest of the document to not show overflow. Therefore, the document itself isn't scrolling and event is not firing. But you can see document scrolling and you can scroll the document, but the event was not firing. So you want to be careful in such scenarios. Small mistake like this can affect a lot in case of JavaScript. That's it for me, guys. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below, ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.